This is a review of the ASUS G73JH-A2 notebook. ASUS has really exceeded expectations this time. First of all, they included a rubberized finished palm rest, which is also fingerprint resistant. The same with the lid, which is also a rubberized finish, and it is also fingerprint resistant. At first glance, the notebook looks pretty sleek for what it offers. On a closer inspection, you can clearly tell that this is no lightweight. The front of the notebook is ergonomically inclined towards the user. You have a row of indication lights here: power, battery, hard drive, and wireless function. On the right-hand side of the notebook, you have a card reader, two USB ports, an HDMI port, and a VGA port. On the back side of the notebook, you have two huge radiators, a dummy antenna jack, a lock port. On the left side, we have a network interface, a USB port, an optical drive. The G73JH-A2 comes with a standard DVD RW. The A1 comes with a Blu-ray drive. Another USB port, a mic, and headphones out. The top of the screen has a web camera. These three buttons control the notebook's lights, turbo mode, which we'll get into later, and Splendid technology. This is a built-in chiclet illuminated keyboard. The touchpad here is actually humongous by comparison to most notebooks. This is what the notebook looks like in the dark. All the lights can be controlled, including that one in the center. The keyboard luminosity can also be controlled from the keyboard using the function keys. The keyboard function keys control everything from sleep to wireless to keyboard lights, LED brightness, external output, touchpad disable, and audio. ASUS bundles a few accessories with this model: a Razer mouse, which matches the finish of the palm rest, a 150 watt adapter to power the dedicated ATI HD 5870 video card, cable ties, restore media, drivers, and Windows 7 Home Premium. It also bundles a very nice ASUS branded Targus made backpack. If you try to use the notebook and open the browser, the first thing you notice is ASUS set the homepage to asus.us.msn.com. This actually causes the notebook to stop responding. This is not the first time this has happened. This has happened under G51 series as well. If you let it go a few minutes and you might have to restart, it will tell you that you need a Microsoft Silverlight update. Agree to it. Once you install the Silverlight update, everything should work as it should. Remove the home page here and set your own. It's important to remember that ASUS sells this notebook globally, and they do bundle different specifications depending on where you buy it. They can put in a lower CPU to less RAM, less hard drive, even no accessories, and even a lower warranty. So always be sure to check the model. This notebook comes with two speakers right above the keyboard on the left and right side. It also has a subwoofer that has a nice little kick to it. The view angles of this notebook are actually phenomenal, everywhere from left to right, even the verticals. The colors don't wash out. They do wash out if you start to look underneath. And this is probably not more than a 70 degree angle. Well, the price, power, and aesthetically pleasing design of this notebook are nothing to sneeze at. This notebook has some major downfalls. One of them is battery life. At around 90% remaining, you get roughly an hour and 37 minutes. Another miss is an absence of an express card and an absence of a FireWire port. Makes one wonder how much money they saved by not integrating both. Another area where ASUS is an innovator is their totally latchless lid. which has no latch. In the notebook's off state, this button here in the center serves as ExpressGate's power button. This is ASUS's version of a watered-down operating system that boots up in under 8 seconds and let you control web to music and pictures. Under the hood, we have two hard drives, three memory banks, another fourth memory goes on the other side under the keyboard, a video card, wireless card goes here, and an 8-cell battery slides into the back. Under the keyboard and entire palm rest cover, you'll find the fourth memory socket and basically the main board. To get to the CPU and video card, the main board does have to be flipped over. The two radiators on the corners, one is for the video card and the other is for the CPU. These are pretty heavy-duty radiators and fans, a lot thicker than your normal fans. You probably will never have to clean them, just give it a good blast of air right through the radiator, and that should keep your notebook going for many years. Self-service is probably not an option here. 3D Mark 2006 at base settings with 1280 by 1024 resolution rates the computer at 12,495 total score, 5100 SM2, 6056 HDR, and the CPU score is 3099. This is with twin turbo mode disabled. Next test will be with twin turbo mode enabled. This notebook stays relatively cool. Palm rests are pretty cool. The keyboard gets a little warm. This is where most of the components are housed, right under the keyboard. Even the backside doesn't get above 100 Fahrenheit. That's all thanks to the two massive cooling fans. The notebook is very quiet even during testing. That is one of its main selling points. The same test rerun with 3D Mark 06 at base resolution with twin turbo mode enabled reveals not much of a difference, a very, very slight improvement. PC Mark Vantage scores this laptop with a whopping 6,680 points. A lot more than expected. 3D Mark Vantage gives it a total score of 8,044 points, with the CPU scoring 10,730.